Good morning, I'm Clinton Griffiths coming to you from Seymour, Illinois, near Champaign at the BASF Research Farm. And we've been checking out crops here. That's after Pro Farmer forecast Illinois to have a whopping 212 bushel an acre yield for corn, the highest of the seven states surveyed during the Pro Farmer crop tour. Now this area could see some rain today as one storm system in the west meets up with the remnants of Hurricane Ida. And right now, people in Louisiana are getting a look at the scope of the damage caused by that massive storm that crashed into the state on Sunday. Damage in some areas of the Category 4 hurricane are reported to be catastrophic, with sustained winds as strong as 150 miles per hour and storm surge up to 15 feet. Plus, waters are continuing to rise following torrential rains, causing rivers to overflow. Now, the National Weather Service is warning parts of southeastern Louisiana could be uninhabitable for weeks. It could also take days for utility crews to assess the damage to the power grid in New Orleans alone, as the entire city lost electricity. Damage assessment is also ongoing along the lower Mississippi area and what it could mean for exports. The port region of South Louisiana moves more tonnage than any other North American port. Grain and soybean shipments from the Gulf account for about 60% of U.S. exports.
And the good news is we've got what looks to be a pretty healthy supply that can accommodate that demand. But as we all know, if you can't connect supply with demand, the transaction never occurs and farmers will never be profitable. And so that's something that is a real concern for us moving forward. And you know, when you put it within the broader context of a overly subscribed supply chain that is under stress, not only for like containerized shipping, but for bulk vessels as well, all of a sudden you insert a significant weather event like Hurricane Ida, and it can really, you know, essentially add insult to injury.
There are reports several meat and poultry processors in Louisiana were forced to stop operations yesterday as the storm continued to push through. U.S. gas prices also jumped as operations at key refineries were suspended in Louisiana. And though the storm has weakened, it is continuing to cause more problems as it moves north, saturating soils that were already too wet, including the Tennessee Valley, which saw severe flooding just last week.